This poem I'm gonna spit for y'all, it's a poem called "But I Didn't Know," so, you know, hope y'all like it. If only I would have known, then this direction I wouldn't have gone, cause now I'm facing a dead end. I'm fighting to defend in a war I can't win, like a sin. Once you do it, it's done, and it can never be taken away. So now you're stuck with that thought, constantly thinking day to day, where would I be? If I would have never done this, if I would have never said that, if I could turn back the hands of time, press rewind and redo all the things I never said and all the things I didn't do. I cleared my mind from cloudy weather to get my thoughts together. Man, I swear I do whatever, whatever it took to make everything all better. But some of us have done such wrong, our sense of right seems numb. How can we think we're in the right when we're as left as they come? But maybe you still don't get it. So picture this. At the young age of 26, you sit nervously in a doctor's room, room 202. Two doctors walk in, four eyes gaze at you, but when they finally arrive, they decide it's time that you know that your cancer infested, it spread through your chest, and you don't have much longer to go. They say the cause is nicotine, that makes your inside scream, because you now know it's your fault. You think back, way back to the first pack of cigarettes you bought and cried, if only I would have known. In this direction, I wouldn't have gone, cause now I'm facing a dead end. I'm fighting to defend in a war I can't win, like a sin. Once you do it, it's done, and it can never be taken away. So now you're stuck with that thought, constantly thinking day to day, where would I be if I was in school like I should have been? Not on the corner smoking cools with my so-called friends. Would I be on my deathbed, halfway dead, halfway alive? Would I be scared to close my eyes, not knowing if I survive? Who can win a coma and never be revived? All because I didn't realize. See, if you'd have told me that day, the first day I ever smoked a cigarette, that 10 years later I'd have cancer, and this moment I regret, I would have called you crazy. I would have brushed you off like nappy hair. I would have told you where to go and what's the fastest way to get there. Cause when you're doing such wrong, man, don't it feel so right? It's like the light when I hit to, this is the last time. That was a line, just a line I told my mind to fool my mind for the moment, but hold it. There's this feeling like I'm happy, like I'm flying. But that feeling doesn't last long, cause in reality, I'm dying. Killing myself with this feeling leaves my soul crying. Now my mind is a wreck, you don't realize the cause until you felt the effect. But maybe smoke is not your thing, so you should picture this thing. Nothing's ever what it seems, nothing's ever out of range. So as you cough, the leaves your body feeling strange. And you know it's not a cold, but still you just can't quite put your finger on it. So out the bed you get as you your way right now to the doctor's office. And now you're coughing, and the doctor's watching, and as he's watching, he hears you coughing, and he thinks he knows just what the problem is. He takes a sample of your blood back to the lab to test. Then he comes back, eyes facing the ground, like he has something heavy to confess. You're only 19 years of age, which is why it rips this doctor to shreds, because he has to be the one to tell you you now have HIV AIDS. You gasp for air and almost choke, because you think back to the one and only time that your protection broke. It only takes one time. Now your disease infested, left dying, crying. If only I would have known, then this direction I wouldn't have gone, because now I'm facing a dead end. I'm fighting to defend in a war I can't win, like a sin. Once you do it, it's done, and it can never be taken away. So now you're stuck with that thought, constantly thinking day to day, what would I be if I would have kept my secrets a secret like my grandmother told me, and not giving out to fake love that I knew was phony? Would I be afraid to tell a soul, not knowing what they would say? Would I be afraid to lose my health with chemotherapy? Would I not know how to handle all the thoughts that flood me? Would I be afraid to tell my parents and feelings they might judge me? But if you would have told me that day, the first day I decided to lose my virginity, that 2 days later I'd be diagnosed with AIDS and my partner wouldn't even remember me, I would have called you crazy. I would have kicked you to the curb like a soccer ball kick. I would have told you, yo, I ain't catching AIDS, man. Ain't nothing protection can't fix, right? Well, that's when my protection broke and I ended up like this. Why, oh, why didn't I trust in abstinence, you know, to refrain from sex till marriage, leaving no room for oops, accidents, brothers. There are only two ways to handle this, and that's through Jesus Christ and through cold showers. Let's be honest, when you're really in the zone, you're just trying to get it on with no thoughts working, possibly make me kind of sort of go wrong 2 days later. When you're really in the zone, you're just trying to get it on with no thoughts of what can possibly, maybe, kind of, sort of go wrong 2 days later. But maybe you still don't get it. So let me go ahead and bring it home now. Let's say you're the type of person that can never be wrong You're 87 years of age and just got through signing your will. How does it feel to know that the end is near? You see a light over your shoulder and you now know that the end is here. You think back to memories in your head as death creeps up your legs. See, this time, you won't die from cancer, nor will you die from age, but you will die a beautiful death, a death full of old age. This time, not cancer, not AIDS, old age.